What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you for stopping by. Today I'll be bringing you the 12th episode in our Atomic Heart game playthrough series, and I hope you'll enjoy it. If you like video game content of all kinds, make sure to leave a like and subscribe and turn on that notification bell so you won't miss when I upload. See ya!
Thank you. Saving data.
Access granted.
Crispy critters. An overgrown dumpling like that almost burned me down back in Forrester Village.
You're now fully on, Comrade Major. We won't be able to enter the theater as long as the Belyash is guarding the entrance.
We'll be inside in 5 minutes flat. I can't wait to pay that thing back with interest.
Access granted. Please select the desired
Charles, can you track Petrov's whereabouts?
Unfortunately, no. Petrov is no longer broadcasting. I will track him as soon as he does.
Gotcha. That means he won't do it again. That dirty, rotten scumfuck is hiding away in some dark corner, and he's gonna sit there and hope the robots kill me before I find him.
I ought to warn you that Petrov knows this theater quite well. He has good reason to hope for such an outcome.
Hope is dangerous. It'll lull him into a false sense of security. Give me intel on the theater.
The Maya Plisetskaya Theater was founded at the facility in 1948. It was the first theater in the world to use robots as performers. It is the most famous theater in the Soviet Union, so tickets can be quite hard to come by.
So it's for the rich and powerful.
You have no idea. Before the theater was fully roboticized, party members would order the best ballerinas in the Soviet Union to be transferred here. But after the performers were replaced with robots, it became so successful, it's now easier to get an apartment near the Kremlin than it is to attend a performance here.
Can you tell me anything more useful and less disgusting?
As part of the facility, the theater is without a doubt a scientific establishment. Its artistic vein is melded with commerce, as is the study of robot behavior and human reactions to it. I have no combat-related data.
How does Petrov know this theater so well?
It was one of the areas his activities were focused on before he was declared a traitor.
So, He's a nostalgic puppet master, huh?
He configured and tested the theater's robots, and also programmed and studied the interplay of various crafts. In a certain sense, Kollektiv was born on the stage of this theater.
Let's go see what's what.